Hi, I'm Dr. Thurston Bauer, and I'm a cardiothoracic surgeon. I practice here at CHI St. Vincent's Infirmary in Little Rock, Arkansas. So end-stage heart failure is, as it sounds, it's the end stages of this chronic disease, usually of heart failure. There's many kinds. There's systolic and diastolic heart failure, but it all essentially comes down to the common point that the heart is not able to pump enough blood around the body to support the rest of the body. That can result in a lot of symptoms such as fatigue, shortness of breath, sometimes chest pain, abdominal bloating, swelling in the legs, fluid retention, things like that. We have a lot of medications that are excellent for treating heart failure, but essentially it comes down to the fact that it is a structural problem. So for many patients, you know, they will continue to progress in severity in their heart failure despite treatment with medications. And then, you know, the ventricle is the more muscular part of the heart and the one that is predominantly responsible for pumping the blood to the body. And as the heart fails, this tends to dilate and lose some of its contractility. So it struggles to pump that blood to the rest of the body. Some of the options would be cardiac transplant and left ventricular assist devices. And a left ventricular assist device is a mechanical pump that can be implanted in the body. It takes blood from the ventricle, puts it through the motor and the pump, and then out to the aorta to the rest of the body. And it truly assists the ventricle. It doesn't take over for the ventricle. We leave the ventricle there. The patients maintain the rest of their heart. It's just that it provides assistance to deliver blood to the rest of the body. So I'm very grateful for the trust that our referring physicians and families and patients have and coming to us and giving us the privilege to help take care of them.